gypsies lived in the east, and they were broad and bonny old. They sang so sweet at the castle gate that they charmed the heart of the lady old. She gave to them the sparkling wine. She gave to them the brandy old, and the gay gold ring that the lady wore. She gave to the dark-eyed gypsy, oh. When the lord of the castle, he came home and inquired for his lady, oh. She is gone, she is gone, said the young servant boy. She's away with the dark-eyed gypsy, oh. Come saddle to me my milk-white steed. The bay is ne'er so speedy, oh. And I ride for a day and a whole long night, till I find my own wedded lady, oh. Then Charles put spurs onto his horse, and off they rode so speedy, oh. And the road came to with his own wedded love, along with the dark-eyed gypsy, oh. Are you going to leave your house and land? Are you going to leave your children three? I will leave them all for the one I love, and I follow my dark-eyed gypsy, oh. Last night I lay on a fine feather bed, my own wedded lord beside me, oh. But this night I lie on the cold barn floor, in the arms of my dark-eyed gypsy, oh. Away, away, I can stay no longer. The sweet and water I mean to cross, o'er high hills and lofty mountains, to spend the night with my own wee lass. Though the night be dark as dungeon, I am not a star there didn't appear. I will be guided without a stumble into the arms of my dear. Slowly I crept up to my love's window, and slowly knelt down upon a stone, and through a pane I softly whispered, saying, "Mary, darling, are you at home?" When slowly, slowly the door she opened, I'm slowly, slowly I slipped in, and there we lay in each other's arms, till the long night 'twas nearly in. Oh, go away and ask your mother if she is willing my bride you'll be. If she says no, come back and tell me, 'tis the last night I will trouble you. I need not go, nor ask my mother, for tales of love she can't endure. She will bid me go, I in court another. Then I whispered in her ear, oh, go away and ask your father if he is willing my bride you will be. If he says no, come back and tell me, 'tis the last night I will trouble you. I need not go, nor ask my father, for he's in his chamber all at his ease. Aye, and in his hand he holds a letter, which reads, much love unto your displease. What makes them speak so ill of me, love? A loyal lover unto you I have been. A loyal lover and a constant sweetheart, true to you I have always been. For I will climb a high, high mountain, where I'll eat nothing but the wild herons. Aye, and I will only drink the tears that are shed from my true love's eyes. For the long night 'twas nearly ended, and drawn nigh till the break of day, I said, my darling, the conchs are crowing, it's now full time that I was away. For after dawning there comes a morning, aye, and after morning there comes a day, aye, and after one love there comes another. We need not hold them that will that way. There was a woman lived in our town, she'd a daughter, Mary Ann, and she kept her daughter locked in a room for fear she'd away with a man. How do I get to your chamber, love, and how do I get to your bed? Oh, my mother locks the door at night, and the keys lie under her head. Ride-a-dee-dum-tie-day, ride-a-dee-dum-tie-day, hurrah for the tour-i-ay. Oh, get a handy ladder made of 30 steps and 3, and put it up to the chimney top, come down in the creel to me. So he got a handy ladder made 30 steps and 3, and he put it up to the chimney top and down to the creel to she. Ride-a-dee dum tie day, ride-a-dee dum in the tour-i-ay, hurrah for the tour-i-ay. Oh, no rest could the old woman get with thoughts running through her head. I bet me life, says the gay old wife, there's a man in me daughter's bed. No rest could the old woman get till she would rise and see, and her foot came again that stumbling block, and into the creel fell she. Ride-a-dee dum tie day, ride-a-dee dum in the tour-i-ay, hurrah for the tour-i-ay. The young man at the chimney top, and he gave the rope a haul, and he broke the ribs on the old woman's side, and a rope came again the wall. So here's to the blue and the bonny, bonny blue, and the blue I love so well, and the old woman that's jealous of her daughter, may she ride in the creel to hell. Ride-a-dee-dum-tie-day, ride-a-dee-dum in the tour-i-ay, rap in the tour-i-ay.
There was a squire in Edinburgh town, and a squire of a high degree. He fell in love with a comely girl, and a comely girl was she. She sought consent from father and mother, from old and young likewise. But alas, she cried, I am undone, as the tears fell from her eyes. She wrote her love a letter, and sealed it with her right hand. And she told him she was to be wedded to a very rich farmer's son. And the very first line he looked over it, he cried, smiled, and thus did say, I might deprive him of his bride all on his wedding day. He sent her back an answer, and that without delay. He sent her back an answer for to be sure to be dressed in green, and a suit of the same I will put on, your wedding I'll prepare. Oh, my dearest, dear, it's with you I'll wed, in spite of all that's there. Then he looked east and he looked west, and all around the land. He selected a score of fine young men, all of a Scottish clan. And they rode on in twos and threes, and a single man rode he. And away they went to the wedding house, with the company dressed in green. Oh, welcome, and oh, welcome, where have you spent the day? Or did you see those gentlemen that passed along this way? He smiled at her, he scoffed at her, he laughed and then did say, they might have been some fairy troops that rode along this way. She filled him a glass of Newport wine, and he said to the company in room, oh, where is the man they say, the man they call him groom? Oh, where is the man they say that will enjoy the bride? For another might like her as well as him, and take her from his side. Then out spoke the bachelor, with a voice so loud and clear, saying, if it's for fight that you've come here, I am the man for thee. It's not for fight that I've come here, but friendship for to show. Give me one kiss from your bonny, bonny bride, and away from you I'll go. He caught her by the middle smart, and by the grass green sleeve, and he marched her out of the wedding house of the company, ask no leave. The drums did beat, and the morning sun, most glorious to be seen. And away they went to Edinburgh town, with the company dressed in green. Caro, sheer fion lewem ma wuchelino. Caro, sheer fion lewem al ylse sto. Efioch se fol erocht a was vino. Agus cori molaba time broche. Cada dish eg do yinier a wuchelino. Cada dish eg do yinier a liel sa stor. Dish ikin yinieva flatini oor. Agus kori molaba time broche. Cadog yr edahyr a fwchelino. Cadog yr edahyr a leil sy stor. Mofas mochwyd talyf a warin.
upstairs, saying, "Madam, dear madam, there's an old man down in the hall. Stay locked in your chambers, or be jiggers, he'll ruin us all." Now the mistress, she scoffed her and called her a silly fool for taking such notions, eyeing off a poor man at the door, with his breeches all tattered, eyeing torn behind and before, and his whiskers hung down for 20 long inches or more. "Oh, Tom Todger," she says, "if you and I could agree, I would make you a steward, I all over my land for to be. We would sit at one table and would sleep on the soft bed of down, if I only could gain you, Tom Todger from Killilay Town." Lady Margaret, she lay on her fine feather bed, the midnight air blew near, when a ghostly form came to her room and to her din. "Appear, appear," and to her din appear. "Are you my father, the king?" she said. "Are you my brother John? Or are you my true love, William?" she said, "coming home from Scotland, along, along, coming home from Scotland along. I am not your father, the king he said, nor am I your brother John, but I am your true love William, she said, coming home from Scotland along, along, coming home from Scotland along. Oh, Margaret, oh, lady, Margaret, he said, for love or charity, will you give to me the plight in troth that once love I gave thee, that once love I gave thee. I'll not give you back your plight in troth, nor any such a thing, until you take me to my own father's hall, where oft times we have been, where oft times we have been. Oh, he took her to her own father's hall, and there they entered in, and the gates flew open of their own free will, to let young William in. To let young William in. Oh, Margaret, oh, lady, Margaret, he said, for love or charity, will you give to me the plight in troth that once love I gave thee, that once love I gave thee. I'll not give you back your plight in troth, nor any such a thing, until you take me to my own father's hall and marry me with a ring, and marry me with a ring. He took her to her own father's hall, and there they entered in, and they joined their hands in the wedlock bands. He married her with a ring, he married her with a ring. Oh, Margaret, oh, lady, Margaret, he said, for love or charity, will you give to me the plight in troth that once love I gave thee, that once love I gave thee? Then out of her pumpkin she drew a cross, and she landed on his breast, saying, here is back your plight in troth, in heaven your soul find rest, in heaven your soul find rest. The wind may blow and the cocks they may crow, and it's nearly breaking day, and this time that the living would depart from the dead, my love, I must away, away, my love, I must away.
Scarcely find her marrow. She was courted by 9 noblemen, and her plough and boy of Yarrow. A sea went o'er yon high, high hills, and down yon path so narrow, there he spied nine noble men come to fight with him on Yarrow. There was three he slew, and a three withdrew, and a three lay deadly wounded, till her brother John stepped in behind and pierced his body through. Go home, go home, you false young man, and tell your sister sorrow that her true love John lies dead and gone on the Dewey Dens of Yarrow. As he went o'er yon high, high hill, and down yon path so narrow, there he spied his sister. She was coming fast for Yarrow. Oh, brother dear, I've dreamed a dream, and I hope it will not prove sorrow, for I dreamed that you were spilling blood on the Dewey Dens of Yarrow. Oh, sister dear, I'll read your dream, and I know it will prove sorrow, for your true love John lies dead and gone, and a bloody corpse on Yarrow. Now this fair maid's hair hung three quarters long, and the colour of it was yellow, and she tied it round his middle small, and she carried him home to Yarrow. Oh, daughter dear, dry up your tears, and dwell no more on sorrow, for I'll wed you to far higher degree than your ploughman boy of Yarrow. Oh, father, you have seven sons, you can wed them all tomorrow, but a fairer flower there never bloomed than my ploughman boy of Yarrow. There was a lady lived in the west, and she was dressed in green, and she leaned over her father's castle wall for to see the ship sail in. "What is wrong with you?" her father did say. "You look so pale and wan, for you must have some sore sinkiness, or have lain with some young man." "Oh, I have had no sore sickness, but I'm in love with a young man, and the only thing that breaks my heart is what keeps my darling so long. Is he a squire, an earl, or a duke, or a man of noted fame? Or is he young John from the Isle of Man, and that ploughs the raging main? He is neither a lord, a squire, or a duke, or a man of noted fame. But he is young John from the Isle of Man, and that ploughs the raging main. Then I call him down, the salt sea clown, and I bring him here to me. For if he's thinking to gain my daughter's hand, he must leave this country. Oh, father dear, don't be severe, or be cruel unto me. For if you send away young John Barlow, you will get no good of me. And then the king, he called in his merry, merry men, and he called them by one, two, and three. But instead of young John being the very first man, the very last one came he. He entered the room, young John Barlow, and the clothing he wore was silk, and his two blue eyes like the morning star, and his skin as white as milk. I think it's no wonder the king he did say, my daughter's in love with thee. For if I was a woman as I am a man, my bedmate you would be. Oh, will you wed my daughter, he said, will you take her by the hand, and you shall dine at my table and be master over all my land. I will wed your daughter, he said, but she's no match for me. For every pound that she counts down, I can count 33. So fill your glasses to the brim, drink a health to your country. Drink a health to young John from the Isle of Man, and to Lady Owens Burley.
For to be on the cold winter's evening, the fair maid sat waiting alone. She was thinking of her father, likewise her aged mother, and also her true lover John. Young Johnny, he was sweet, and he promised for to meet, but he tarried an hour too long. He met with great delay, which caused him for to stray, and I weary waiting all alone. Young Johnny came at last, and he found the door was fast. He slowly, slowly tinkled at the pane. And this minute she arose, and hurried on her clothes in order to let young Johnny in. He took her in his arms, and off to bed they went, and there they lay talking of their plan. I wish this maid, said she, this night would prove to be as long since the world first began. Fly up, oh fly up, my pretty little conch, and don't crow until it breaks day. and your cage it shall become of the very shining gold, your wings of a silvery grain. But this pretty little clown, so cruel as he was, he crawled out and never too soon, and he sent my love away before the break of day, being only the light of the moon. This fair maid she arose and quickly followed after, and when will you come to see me? When the fishes they do fly, the seas they all run dry, and seven moons shine brightly o'er yon lea. There was once I thought my love was as constant unto me as the stones that lie under yon ground. But now since I do find he has altered his mind, I would rather live single as he found.